It happened inside the University Center Wednesday afternoon. According to students, a campaign worker for conservative candidate Marty Burke showed up. Student Brenna Anstett says she was marking her ballot at a table.
A guy walked up, made a big scene, was claiming that the station was illegal, and went to grab for the box. I didn't see if he got his hand on it.
Student Colin Cooper says he saw it from his place at the front of the line of voters.
He was saying that it wasn't a recognized poll, and he put his hand on the ballot box. And I think he was just gesturing towards it, but then they told him, you know, you can't touch the ballot box. And they moved the ballot box and they told him you have to get back because he was interrupting the voting.
It happened after a big push on campus to convince students to vote.
I'm actually really quite disturbed. I was very, very proud of the students.
Alistair Summerlee is the university's president.
They've spent a lot of time trying to make sure that people are aware they should vote and do it in a non-partisan way.
So no political science within the voting area?
No, absolutely none. None that I saw.
This is Marty Burke's campaign headquarters. A staff member here says Burke is out campaigning and can't be reached to comment on the situation.
In a statement released this afternoon, Elections Canada says the students' votes are legitimate. All information at our disposal indicates that the votes were cast in a manner that respects the Canada Elections Act and are valid. Elections Canada says the polling station was supervised, but it was not authorized. Once Elections Canada officials were made aware of the local initiative in Guelph, the returning officer was instructed not to engage in any further activities of a similar nature. All returning officers have received this instruction. Student Brenna Anstett says the experience hasn't turned her off politics.
Personally, it doesn't discourage me. It actually makes me want to get involved more.
Now, the decision by Elections Canada comes as a great relief to the more than 700 students who lined up here to vote on Wednesday. Nancy.
Now, this, of course, is already impacting on the campaign trail. So let's go to CTV's Roger Smith. He's in Sudbury, traveling with Liberal leader Michael Ignatieff. And Roger, what is Mr. Ignatieff saying about all of this?
Well, we haven't talked to him since the decision came down from Elections Canada, but obviously this plays into the narrative that the Liberals prefer, that the Tories are acting in an undemocratic way. The Tories challenged this voting at Guelph. They tried to nullify those votes, and Elections Canada ruled against them. Also, you know, these could be quite crucial votes in that riding. It's narrowly won last time by the Liberals, and it's believed that many of the university students would probably a greater number would tilt away from the Conservatives. So those votes could be decisive in the riding, and it probably doesn't look good on the Conservatives that they tried to nullify those votes. Mm-hmm.
Well, and in fact, one of the workers for the local candidate tried to grab the ballot box and run off with it. What's your thoughts on this, especially in light of the fact we're trying to get students to vote?
Yeah, you know, this is part of a pattern. First, you have a prime minister who checks the Facebook page of people coming to his meetings, demands an identity check on everybody coming to the meetings, and then you have a conservative operative trying to grab a ballot box at a university in a town where precisely that's the place where students were mobilizing to get out the vote. The president of the university was challenging students to mobilize the vote. And hey, presto, the conservatives come in and grab a ballot box. I mean, I've been saying throughout this election that democracy itself is an issue. Do you respect democracy? The first thing you need to have in a prime minister is a prime minister who's think, yeah, let's get more kids out to vote. Let's get more students involved. Let's not suppress the vote. And let's make respect for democracy a central part of what we expect of a prime minister. This is part of a pattern, and Canadians need to know it's worrying. And I can't believe it. I mean, let me go on just one more minute. You know, one in five of Canadians who turned 18 in 2008 bothered to vote at all. What kind of message does that conduct send to those young Canadians? You got to check your Facebook page before you can go to a political meeting. And when you do try to vote on a campus, some political party comes in and tries to grab the ballot box. I mean, you know, a politician has two loyalties here, a loyalty to his party and a loyalty to the democratic system. I'd like to see some loyalty to the democratic system from the prime minister.
The opposition is painting the conservatives as anti-democratic after the party pushed to have some votes thrown out. Here's CTV's Richard Madden with the latest details.
Stephen Harper was campaigning for the seniors' vote, but it's the student vote that's causing his party headaches. That case, an advanced voting booth at the University of Guelph. Conservative lawyers demanded Elections Canada disqualify 700 ballots because no party scrutineers were around to monitor goings-on.
The president of the university was challenging students to mobilize the vote, and hey, presto, the conservatives come in and grab a ballot box. I mean, I've been saying throughout this election that democracy itself is an issue.
In a statement, Elections Canada says the votes will stand, saying no scrutineers are required at special ballot locations.
What happened in this case, I think, is we saw the curtain open a little bit on a vote suppression effort by the Tories. They're going to try now to shut down university voting across the country in order
excellent.
To ensure that
doing.
Those downtown ridings with huge numbers of university students don't get the vote.
Well,
yeah,
you guys are really
makes sense.
Reaching
if I was
this.
A conservative, I want to shut it down.
I completely
sure.
agree.
No.
You know, I think a lot of this has been a Rovian strategy of voter suppression, but it's also indicative, again, of the Prime Minister's attitude to organizations that he disagrees with. And, you know, this is all mucked about in the Elections Canada thing, you know. If it's a rule that works in his favor, he's going to support it. But if it's like in and out, something like that, well then, you know, it's demonizing another democratic institution. Again, this is
Sheila,
part of the
please.
Harper MO.